Hello, I'm Mike Nelson from Campbell Scientific, and today I'm here to talk about the setup of a Campbell Scientific DCP. And the DCP is going to consist of a CR300 data logger along with a TX321 GOES transmitter. The TX321 transmitter has a couple screw holes on the top here where I can actually just take the CR300 and mount it right to it, so it becomes a single package, easily mounted on a board or used in a gauge house just on the shelf there. Today we're also going to be working with a radar stage sensor and a newer style tipping bucket rain gauge. So we're going to set up a DCP to give us water level and to give us rain precipitation. And I'm going to be working with the data logger, GOES transmitter mounted together, but it's pre-wired so I don't have to go through the wiring. But it is just a standard SDI-12 and tipping bucket rain gauge, so very simple on the wiring there. So that's what we're going to be working with as we go through this interface.
HydroLink can be found at our website, www.campbellsci.com, and then by coming over to the search window and searching for Hydro-Link, you'll see the link to it right here. Once I get in there, I see the general overview and benefits of HydroLink. I can also come to very specific areas of the webpage here for HydroLink. If I go to the download section, I see where I have a download as an install and also as a zip file. Both result in the same installation once done properly. The main reason for having two different types is to provide the best way for you to get past security issues that you may have on your end. Also, you have the HydroLink installation guide. I'd suggest downloading this here, you know, opening it up and following those instructions, which will make sure that you get the install done correctly. Once HydroLink is installed, it's very easy at that point to come in and create a shortcut for it.